So, screens are impossible to avoid. In this day and age, everywhere you go, you'll see a screen. You know, your phone has a screen on it. Your computer monitor is a screen. Your TV is a screen. Even in some cars, they have screens on the dashboard for like radio, navigation, things like that. And even though they're so common, a lot of people still don't even know how they work. So, this is what I'm going to explain in this video. How screens slash monitors work. So basically, the universal, like, fundamental way that they work is a screen is made up of thousands of tiny little lights or pixels, and these pixels are able to generate, you know, one color at a time. And when every single pixel generates a different color in unison, they can create a picture, an image. So that's what you see when you look at a screen. You're actually not looking at, you know, an image. It's actually just a bunch of tiny little colors that are brought together by a computer to create the image. But there's a lot of different ways that these pixels can be arranged or lit up to create the desired image. So that's what I'm going to explain next. There are two main types of screens that we use now. We have an LCD, which is a liquid crystal display, and an LED, which is a light-emitting diode. So, firstly, we have the LCD. Okay, essentially, for an LCD screen, also known as a liquid crystalline screen, basically it breaks down like this. The screen is made up of multiple layers, and each layer has a significant purpose. The first layer is just a blank, it's a screen emitting white light, fluorescent white light. And as we know, white light is the presence of all colors. So every single color in the rainbow is within that white light. It's in there somewhere, we just can't see it. So then we have three other layers on top of that. There's a polarizing filament. There's two layers of polarizing filament. One is negatively charged and one is positively charged. Then in between those two layers of polarizing filament, there's a layer of a rare substance called liquid crystalline. And when you combine all of these elements or these screens or layers together and shine the white light through it, they filter out the white light and basically are able to generate every color needed for every single pixel that will have to project some color or another later on. Each pixel in these filter screens has their frequency charged by electrical signals coming from the top and sides of the screen, causing it to let through a different color of light every time. So that's how you get the colors in each pixel. All right, now the second type of screen that's very popular that you'll see nowadays is called an LED screen. And that stands for light emitting diode. All right, so the way that LED screens are different from LCD screens is instead of having multiple layers creating the difference in color, each individual pixel has its own set of three lights. One that's red, one that's green, one that's blue. Now, the computer that controls the pixels can light up each light according to what shade of color it needs to be. So if you needed to make purple, the blue and the red would light up, but not the green, etc. With various wavelengths being applied to each pixel, the color of each pixel is determined through the combination of the three colors, red, green, and blue. Thank you for watching.